with our Milky Way descendants. As of now, beacons confirming arrival in Helios remain unanswered. This is HNS.
Harry, what's happening with Sarah?
Well, we got her out of the pod. I don't want to get your hopes up, but Sam managed to, find her, you might say.
I don't follow.
Well, she's still in a coma. But she also has an implant like yours, and Sam managed to access it. He's made contact.
I wouldn't think that's even possible.
You and me both, but Sam, well, I guess supercomputers have a different view of things.
Though in a coma, Sarah's mental processes remain intact.
So, is she okay?
You can ask her yourself. A moment while I establish a link with her implant. Proceed.
Sarah? Can you hear me?
Scott? Is that you? What's happening? Where am I?
There was a problem with your stasis pod. You're in a coma, on the Hyperion. Do you understand?
I think so. Am I dreaming?
Sam linked into your implant, but they say you're stable. You're safe and sound in the medbay.
This is so weird. I hear you, but I can't feel anything. Where's Dad? Is he doing okay?
He's away on a mission right now. I know he's worried about you, though.
Yeah, I know Dad. He probably said, "She'll live." I went off to go study some new form of algae.
It wasn't like that. He cares.
How many times has he yelled at me so far?
Oh, the usual.
Well, when he gets back, tell him he needs to stop picking on my little brother. What's home like? Is Habitat 7 as beautiful as they promised?
There's been some complications. The Golden Worlds didn't exactly deliver.
Damn. Well, we knew it could get rough. Dad will find us a place to live.
Yeah, I'm sure he will.
And I should be there helping you guys do it.
Well, you were never one to quit, Sarah. A little nap won't hold you back.
Hell no, it won't. As soon as I'm up, I'm helping you and Dad find home.
You got it.
And then...
What happened?
The connection was only temporary. Her condition remained stable.
Sorry, it seemed better than nothing. I'll keep you posted, promise.
Thanks, Harry.
Superintendent Cash reminds everyone all power grid adjustments must be approved beforehand.
Isn't what we wanted, but what choice do we have? How the hell should I know? Spender, you have a job. If you want to keep it, do it. God damn it. You've shaken things up, Pathfinder. My department actually has colonial affairs to direct. And you have new tools to help grow the initiative. AVP, ready for spending.
Sam said there was new functionality to discuss.
It's how the initiative was designed to support the Pathfinder. You and your team are out there making Andromeda viable. That empowers all of us. Hit a threshold. A new cryo group can be brought out. Want more focus on research, like on Prodromos? That's your call. Brekka will introduce the interface and handle minutia. All you need to do is decide what life in Andromeda means. No pressure.
Colonial Affairs, please advise Director Tan of your status.
Hello, Pathfinder. I am Cryo Deployment Administrator Vladimir Brekka, C-63 Galati. Your first task is to decide irrevocably the course of every life in the Initiative.
Whoa, that seems like... too much.
Yes, of course. But now you respect what we're doing. Andromeda viability and the Nexus thresholds are your tools, your reward, and our future. How can I help?
What's the rundown on AVP?
Much of the preparation in the Milky Way was determining how to measure success. Thresholds are about capacity, but this is about cost, what we can actually afford to support. Points aren't the most elegant system, but it makes it clear. The more you earn, the more we can deploy.
How are you measuring thresholds?
It's based on resource estimates and the general stability. A metric of acceptable scope and risk. The more you achieve, the greater capacity we can accommodate, the more the Initiative can do for you. Simplest explanation? The more you do, the more room we have to grow.
So, I decide what groups to wake up. Won't everyone be out eventually?
Absolutely. But there's an order to things, lines of support. You can't deploy an omelet without first deploying eggs, and eggs won't get you steak. Except it's people, and how all our lives begin.
All right, Brekka. Where do I start?
The interface is active and will respond only to a Pathfinder. It's ready for your first selection. You may begin shaping the Initiative at your leisure.
Hydroponics reports oxygen
Ryder, isn't it? Kerry Tvesa, freelance vidmaker. This is Hakim, my producer. I could use your help.
What are you looking for?
Director Tanz asked for an uplifting documentary on the initiative. Translation, paint rainbows over our problems. But our problems are history. People deserve the truth, not propaganda.
Nice to see someone so devoted to her work.
That's kind. Sometimes the camera makes people shy away from me.
That's a shame.
So that's what I need. The truth, I mean. Someone needs to record the history we're making.
It takes integrity to record the truth and nothing but.
Well, I do my best. And you could help me out. The heart of my documentary will be an interview series. I was hoping you'd take part. I want the dirt and blood of our story, not the convenient fairy tale Tan's looking for. Interested?
Okay, interview away.
Let's start at home. 14 months and the Nexus still isn't finished. Arcs are missing, we have people in exile. By any standard, this wasn't the plan. Our leadership describes these as anticipated issues. Would you agree?
All expeditions have to deal with supplies, enemies, or hell, just getting lost. We'll deal with all of them. We just need time.
Tan will love that. But if that's your take, that's what goes in. Bandwidth means I'm transmitting in short bursts, so that's all for now. But you can bet I'll have more questions later. This was more fun than I expected. You were great. I'll get to work editing.